So I was just making sure that I didn't do that wrong. In Eldritch Horror, when someone's devoured, doom advances. Not so in this game. So. William's ready to go into that gate. I think Hank's just gonna have a regular encounter in case Hank gets caught up. Or William. I don't know. No, we're gonna do it one time. One time, two clues, 1 in 7 chance. Which one are we gonna do? Let's use our 10-sider again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 2. Whew! We are being spared currently. Alright, so he gets his two clue tokens. Yeah, Ghatanathoa, you jerk. Scaring me. That's it. That's it for the encounter phase. We avoided the servitor of our gods, got uncursed, and we were scared, and we just got those two clue tokens for Hank. But again, depending on this mythos card, we could have Ghatanathoa waking up, and more or less this game is over. Wizard's Hill. Not over, but it could be. D1 Rising track at 5. Ah! Because, again, just, Wizard's Hill has an elder sign, so it's saying nope. Clue cannot appear at Gardener's Place. Circle, diamond, and square. And guys, I believe we have just. Nope. Diamond on white. Woo! If diamond was on black, we would have lost right there. So, boom, boom, boom. The logger. Not an issue. So I always. There's someone in the street right next to him. So Servitor just follows William. Will checks minus one, lore checks plus one. Flyers do not move to or from the sky because of the angry red sky. So, regardless, he went to go see his friend over there, right? Rules, 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 rules. All right, so this Mythos card says that flying monsters do not move to or from the sky. Flying monsters. When they move, they look for someone in the street adjacent first before moving. So I'm going to say that yes, he does move to William because that makes sense. It would not make sense for him to say, oh, there's an investigator. I'm going to move up to the merchant district. So that's that mythos phase. We're still toying with just overall danger here. Yorick is going to have to again get past the servitor here. So Marie, she's gonna get that last clue token that she needs on this turn. That's all she's gonna do. I'm moving quick here. I mean, obviously, upkeep still has to happen, but there's not really much upkeeping to do at this juncture. Hank also just needs one more clue, and he can, he's got lots of goodness when it comes to monster trophies and gate trophies and all that jazz. I'm not going to have him do the twofer again. I don't feel like him getting devoured. So I don't know what I want to do. Anyway, sent him to Innsmouth. I mean, push comes to shove. Someone's got to be there to take on the madness that is going on down there. So, with his focus, we're going like this. I'm going to spend this in advance. Buck. All right, Hank. 1, 2, 3, 4, train station. To 5, Joe Sargent's bus service. And he's like, what's up, y'all? Hank Sampson here. I ain't scared. Hasn't had a horror check the entire game. So what that does is if a fast monster like the Shuggoth, he's going to stop. He's going to run into Hank and say, I don't want to go into Vortex. I want to mess around with this dude. I also can use clue tokens to fill up this clue track and get rid of the Deep One Rising's track. So lots of different things I can do. 4 is not going to do anything. You have to fill that all the way up. Once you get to 6, it eliminates all of the Deep One Rising tokens. So he's just going to sit there. He's going to be like, you know, sitting by his merry self waiting for monsters to come to him. Because he's just a brave, brave dude that way. So thanks, Hank. And then Yorick, same kind of thing here. We need to have him get past this brute. We did so. A servitor can be scary, but not when you got that type of sneak. And William finally gets to the gate. All right. So Lambeau is going to have a historical society encounter here. And her, by the way, her gate, you know, the Grand Marie thing, I mean, it's not all that useful right now. I'm more scared of that 10th gate getting open. So it is what it is at this juncture. All right, let's see where she's going to be encountering here. 10, I'll be right back. Make a luck minus 2 check. If you pass, then while paging through the historical records, you come across a piece of information that makes everything come together for you. If you have fewer than 5 clue tokens, gain enough clue tokens to get up to 5. If you fail, nothing happens. So either way, nothing happens because she has 5 clue tokens. So, okay. So nothing happens times 2. Hank is just sitting there. No encounter for him. And Yorick, finally, let's see if we can win this game. Goes through to the Great Hall of Selenio, where he will have a blue or green encounter here to start things off. If he loses sanity, I think that may be it. Oh, Selenio, a lurking monster appears. I'm really glad that his sneak is down, or up, or whatever you want to call it. This could be bad. We're all stressing out here. William knows the urgency. He knows that he needs to seal this gate. Ghatanathoa is that close, just waking up. The Deep Ones are rising. There's gates popping up all over the place. He's got 1 sanity left. He's done all he can. And, okay, he gets a ghoul. Not going to be able to sneak past the ghoul, that's for sure. But I should be able to not worry about the ghoul. Five dice for the will check. Six dice because of the +1 for horse check. Okay, we're good. Okay. And the fight check, 2. 4. 9. -1 is 8. So the horde check was what I was scared of, and it was a very easy monster to take care of. So luckily we're not gonna worry about that, and we're gonna totally pass this. We totally did. With flying colors, with 4 successes. And yet another monster trophy for Yorick. That works, but was all this for naught? Was all this for naught? Has Ghatanathoa just been toying with us? Has he been toying with us? Here we go. All right, so I have to decide what I want to do here. I specifically took 20, whatever, 5 Mythos cards randomly. But it's telling me to shuffle the Mythos deck. I'm not going to mess around with that. So what we're going to do is, I'm going to shuffle all of those Mythos cards into the big deck. I'm going to count, I'll probably just end up, I'm not going to do it totally random. I'm just going to shuffle a bunch and I'll be back. Alright, so I lied. There were 122 Mythos cards left. I used random.org to choose the 24th Mythos card. I have not looked yet. I am freaked out. This game could all come down to this. Alright, so Gardener's Place. We're fine. Sort of. Probably not. But what happens is, yes, it says that there's a gate surge. If that was sealed, a gate would be placed there. Doom would not go up. So, it's not sealed, though, which means it's just a normal monster surge. So, I need to grab lots and lots and lots of monsters. So, let's hope for the best. I'll be right back. Alright, can I just say we got extremely lucky here? The game is not over. Game is not over. So what we've got here is the octagonal, dash, triangle, and star all moving. So the monsters that we got in the worst ones did not have those symbols. So Ghatanathoa and Double Reef, not a problem. None of the monsters in Innsmouth are moving, except for this here ghoul. It goes there. This ghoul moves on black. The Night Gaunt, they don't move the sky, so they're going to move just regularly and move down here. And so the monster limit is 6. And so that means that we had 2 monsters go here, outskirts go up, terror track goes up 1, we lose 1 ally, and all the monsters go into the bag. So the terror limit, terror track did go up. Now, one thing I didn't think about is martial law. One second. So the other thing about Innsmouth is martial law. When you end your movement and the Ancient One's deep track is at least half full, which it is, then Hank needed to pass a sneak check to avoid being arrested. So that can change things quite a bit here as well. I'm going to do that from the last turn. He's going to stay there probably this turn, and so he's going to have to do this again. We got lucky, so he's fine. So after all of that movement, there is, we're okay. The game is not over. We're dang close, though. All right, clue appears at the Cold Spring Glen and Bishop Brooks Bridge. Done. This is a good one. Investigators who end their movement in the East Town streets may draw 2 common items and purchase 1, none, or both of them at the list price. So East Town, Eastwood Streets. East Town Streets? East Town Streets. So that's right there. Gets rid of that Mythos card. We're hanging in by the skin of our chinny chin chin. I'll be back. So it more or less comes down to 2 turns now, y'all. And by the way, I listened to my last video, the sniffling. I'm sorry, I realized that I have, my cold is affecting even the quality of these videos. So apologies. But again, stuff that you learn when you do your first video. So we have this situation here where we need 2 turns. So William, unless he gets, no, there's nothing he can do at this juncture to get home on this turn and close that or seal that gate. So we need 2 turns. And the issues that we have is that if another gate opens, Ghatanathoa awakes. If a elder sign location is chosen, a deep one rising occurs, and Ghatanathoa awakes. And if the monsters move into any of the vortices, Ghatanathoa awakes. So I'm kind of at a loss to think about how we're going to keep all of that from happening at this juncture. Because, you know, Hank's not going to be able to get past all these monsters into Falcon Point and go to... we would have to get so extremely lucky at this juncture. So we're going to play this turn out. We're going to see how it goes. But I still think Ghatanathoa has a very good shot of getting this one in the back against our investigators. So Hank here... I mean, the Shuggoth probably would be one that would be worthwhile, but I don't really want to move him out of Joe's Sergeant bus service, necessarily. I mean, I think I'm just going to keep him there. It's not like it's going to matter a whole lot regardless. If I could go to Double Wreath or Yanlathe, I would, but I can't get there. So, he is going to have to pass a sneak test to not get arrested, so we're gonna just move this down to 2, so that way we get 3 dice, because that's gonna end his movement. Alright, he did get arrested. He did not get arrested. He's just gonna hang around and hope that monsters go and, well, that they don't move past him into a vortex. So, there's that. William, anything to do in upkeep here? I like his sneak situation. Nope. So he moves to the Great Hall of Selenio. And Marie, I mean, at this juncture, whatever she does is not going to matter a whole lot. She has enough clues to go seal a gate, but she's not going to be able to move to a gate this turn. Again, it really all comes down to that Mythos card, so... she's going to go and... I mean, if we could somehow zap a monster or something... You know, discard one monster of your choice type things. I know that I have a feeling that maybe happens in the science building, so we're gonna just move there. So I don't know. I know there's some weird machines in the science building, so that's, we're gonna kind of do a Hail Mary there. So Hank does not have an encounter. William will have his other world encounter, and Marie's gonna have a science building encounter, and that's all we've got for this turn. Which again, I'm, you know, obviously somewhat expecting it to be our last turn. But, alright, let me grab this. Alright, the shattered remains of an unusual object lies here. With some perseverance and luck, you might be able to reassemble it. Stay here next turn to make a luck minus one check. Sure. Let's use a clue token. I mean, again, I don't think it's going to matter at this juncture. So, let's try and get this unique item with a luck minus one check. Got it. So we get a unique item, and it's going to win us the game! Oh man, that's pointless. Sacrifices to make. Woohoo! Absolutely worthless at this juncture. So let's go ahead and do Mr. Yorick's Otherworld Encounter. Again, he's in the Great Hall of Selenio, blue or green. We got green, and it's another Selenio one. Make a luck minus two check to find a valuable book. If so, search the unique item deck and take the first tome you find. His luck, unfortunately, is not in a good spot, but luck minus two. I might as well just start getting rid of a couple monster trophies here. So I'm going to see if I can get not on the first and not on the second. So all right. So nothing happens. And really the moment I was working to get towards is just that this next Mythos card, because it's going to determine whether we fight Ghatanathoa or not. And it's Independence Square, which, of course, has a gate. So, but let's look at the symbols before we deal. Yeah, so the triangle, that's going to do it. I'm not even going to go through the gate openings, etc., because that Proto-Shoggoth going into the vortex is going to have the Deep One Risings track go to its max, and therefore Ghatanathoa awakes. Alright, so let's move everything else out of the way here. I mean, I always find these a little tough and anticlimactic because it's like, well, the chances of us doing this are so small. I just don't like the final battles very much because it feels like I've already lost, you know, like he awoke, he did his thing. And the thing is, with minus six on the attack, I haven't prepared for that all game necessarily. My investigators are not really all of that, well, his attack is a little unique. So, I guess it's worth trying. Marie's got multiple hands, and Hank has got his crazy fight that he's got going on, and William is, well, going to die quickly. Minus six. Nah, I'm not going to do it. We're going to call this a loss, guys. And again, you can. It's really up to you as you play Arkham Horror whether you want to fight the evil one, but or the ancient one once he wakes up. But more or less, what would happen is we would have to take care of that that amount of. Hold on. So yeah, sorry. After looking at the rule book, so what happens is, for every four successes, you put a Doom token on his Doom track. And we would need to get 13 times 4 successes, because again, we had Bob, so that would be, you know, 52 successes over more or less 4 rounds. I mean, Hank could live a little bit longer. Hank has 6 speed, so he would last 6 rounds. William would last 3 rounds. Marie would last 4 rounds. But the thought of getting 52 successes with this team is just insane. So Ghatanathoa, well played. So, A, if you've gotten to this point in my video series, I thank you very much, because it was my first go-around. It was my first game or playthrough that I've ever done on Board Game Geek, and I've had a lot of fun. And I hope you've seen the variety that having Innsmouth really adds. We ended up losing the game because of Innsmouth, because of the Deep One Risings track, which I've never had happen before, but because the game went longer, because I was able to kind of keep the Doom track down with Marie and that monster that we took care of and the Elder Sign, we had many ways to keep Doom down. But at the end of the day, Ghatanathoa was a cool opponent, and there was this real fear of getting devoured and getting losing an investigator. And so that's what happened to Bob. And again, my house rule, in my opinion, makes it way more exciting. We would have had a fourth investigator here. I would have risked things a lot more, and we would have kept cycling through investigators. A, that gets fiddly, that, you know. And plus, I just love getting so tied to my investigators. And just thinking about how things went down to the wire, you know, they're all getting freaked out. They're losing their sanity. They know that the world's about to end. They're having these crazy encounters with these crazy gods and these crazy monsters that, you know, they were not prepared for in any way, shape, or form. And so anyway, it's just thematic. It's cool. And man, I just love this game. I love this game. It is my favorite solo game of all time thus far. But the cool thing is that I don't know how cool it is. I now have to go and clean this up because we got Shadows of Malice coming to the table here shortly. One thing I did want to say, you know, just because I feel this is talked about quite a bit, and I don't feel like I'm going to be doing a, I'm not going to be doing a playthrough of Eldritch Horror anytime soon anyway. I may get Mountains of Madness here shortly, and maybe that will be worth doing a playthrough on. But I like this game more than Eldritch Horror, quite a bit more than Eldritch Horror when it comes to just solo play. And I think that Tragic had that same opinion. I think that the Lonesome Gamer had the same. I agree. As a solo gamer, I just feel like this has much more to it in terms of just feeling like you're trapped in this kind of one small area, and these monsters are all over the place. You have to be strategic about how you go around them. You can get trapped. You can get freaked out by these monsters. The monsters have a humongously bigger part in this game than they do in Eldritch Horror. And sure, monsters aren't a huge part of the game, but for me, that means a lot. Yes, there's a lot more thematic encounters sometimes, you could argue, in Eldritch Horror, but at the same time, you know, it feels, because it's so big, it doesn't feel as thematic to me. So because of that, Arkham is definitely my vote over Eldritch. Especially once you get these expansions, this has been great. So, I think I'm going to sign out. Thanks for sticking around. Again, if you have, and, join me next time where my next video should be my first attempt at a, video review as I review Shadows of Malice. Nez is signing off. Thanks so much. Oh, and by the way, please leave feedback. Would love to know what I could do better. Thanks, y'all.